All right, the following will be a series of videos to basically show the overview of the Atwood Scale-O-Matic divider rounder. I'll be going through different sections of the machine. So first we'll just start with the hopper. The unit is designed so that basically you can put dough into the hopper, and that there is a sensor so that when you put the dough in and the cover's on the dough, when the dough comes down and is depleted in the hopper, that sensor will stop the machine. So there has to be dough in the machine for it to run. Now, how we test the machine is that there is right here a test button. So in other words, without having dough because of that sensor in the hopper, you can start the machine and hold the test button and the machine will run without dough. But again, ideally the machine is made to run with dough in it. The power controls, of course, are start and stop, and then you have the switches so that you can, in fact, turn on the small conveyor, which is right up under the safety guard there that takes the dough ball, which I'll show later, so that when it transfers from the divider into the rounder. Again, so you have the two switches, one here for the small little conveyor that goes from the divider into the rounder, and then the other switch for the outfeed conveyor, so once the dough balls are rounded, that they will come out of and drop off into this conveyor. Alright, so the next part that we're basically going to do then is we're going to show the safety. So to start, typically the guard is down and there is a knob or like a nut that unscrews. So once you unscrew it, you basically then can lift up the safety cover, and of course on the safety covers there's also a magnetic sensor so that if for some reason that safety guard is lifted, the machine will stop. So the next part basically would be to remove the stainless steel cover first, which just slides off. Okay, and basically what you can see is the arm that drives the dividing plate with the cup assembly. So let's go ahead and first take off the cup assembly. And basically very simple, once you loosen the screws, then the dividing cup will just slide out so that you can take the unit over to a sink and basically you can rinse it off to get the dough off of the dividing cup. Alright, so go ahead and open up that blank, make sure you have enough room for the parts, you know what I mean? What we will do next, of course, is then we're going to remove the bolts. There are 8 bolts, two that hold part of the safety guard assembly. There's also a nut here. And then, of course, once that happens, and these cover that hold it down on each side will come off. Of course, on one side, there is an oiler that will provide oil that drips down into this sliding assembly so that keeps the steel parts lubricated. Alright, so the next part of the video, for the sake of the size of the video, we'll start with that. So I'm going to stop and start again.